Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, we want to solve the following problem. Given a circle, let ABC be an inscribed triangle with angle BCA equals alpha and tangent alpha equals 20 over 21. Let D be a point on the circle such that AD is the diameter of the circle. Next, extend AB to E and extend AC to F such that EF is perpendicular to AD, and let H be the point where EF intersects AD. Given that AH equals 2HD, EH equals 21 units, and HF equals 20 units, find the length of AC. And now for the solution. First, connect B to D and then consider the lines BD, BC, AD, and AC and the circle. Angle BDA and angle BCA subtend the same arc. Recall that angles subtending the same arc are equal. Therefore, we have angle BDA equals angle BCA equals alpha. Next, consider triangle ABD and the circle. Angle ABD is an angle in a semicircle. Recall that an angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Therefore, we have angle ABD equals 90 degrees. Since tangent alpha equals 20 over 21, let's define the length of AB as 20 m and the length of BD as 21 m, where m is a constant. Then, by Pythagoras' theorem, we have AD squared equals AB squared plus BD squared, or 20 m whole squared plus 21 m whole squared, which equals 400 m squared plus 441 m squared, or 841 m squared. Taking the square root, we obtain AD equals 29 m. Next, consider triangle ABD and triangle AEH. Since this angle is common to both triangles, and angle ABD equals angle EHA equals 90 degrees, therefore we have angle AEH equals angle BDA equals alpha. Following this, consider triangle AEH. In right triangle AEH, we have tangent alpha equals AH over EH, which equals 20 over 21. Since EH equals 21 units, we have AH over 21 equals 20 over 21, and so AH equals 20 units. By Pythagoras' theorem, we have AE squared equals EH squared plus AH squared, or 21 squared plus 20 squared, which equals 441 plus 400, or 841. Taking the square root, we thus have AE equals 29 units. Since AH equals 2HD, we have 2HD equals 20 units, and so HD equals 10 units. The length of AD, which equals AH plus HD, thus equals 20 plus 10, or 30 units. Going back to triangle ABD, since AD also equals 29 m, we have 29 m equals 30, and so m equals 30 over 29. The length of AB, which equals 20 m, thus equals 20 times 30 over 29, or 600 over 29 units. Next, connect C to D and then consider the lines AB, BC, AD, and CD and the circle. Let's define angle ABC as beta. Then, since angle ADC and angle ABC subtend the same arc, we have angle ADC equals beta. Following this, Consider triangle ADC and the circle. Angle DCA is an angle in a semicircle and therefore equals 90 degrees. Next, consider triangle ADC and triangle AHF. Since this angle is common to both triangles, and angle AHF equals angle DCA equals 90 degrees, therefore we have angle HFA equals angle ADC equals beta. Next, consider triangle AHF. Let's calculate the length of AF. By Pythagoras' theorem, we have AF squared equals AH squared plus HF squared. Since AH equals 20 units and HF equals 20 units, AF squared equals 20 squared plus 20 squared, which equals 400 plus 400, or 800. Taking the square root, we thus obtain AF equals 20 square root 2 units. Finally, consider triangle AEF and triangle ACB. Let us show that these triangles are similar. Since angle ACB equals angle AEF equals alpha, and angle CBA equals angle EFA equals beta, by the AA similarity theorem, the two triangles are similar. Since corresponding sides in similar triangles are proportional, we have AC over AE equals AB over AF, or AC equals AB over AF times AE. Substituting the values of the relevant lengths, we thus have AC equals 600 over 29 divided by 20 square root 2 times 29. Simplifying, we therefore obtain AC equals 15 square root 2 units, which is the solution to our problem. As an exercise, try to solve this problem and see if you can get the correct answer. This marks the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more content. Thanks for watching and see you all next time.